Hey guys, so today with us we have the Asus TUF Gaming Laptop. This is a gaming laptop review. So hey, what's up guys, this is Abhishek Gargad, so let's get started. Now let's just speak about the build quality on this machine. This is all made out of premium looking plastic. You have a beautiful cutouts at the back, in the front, on the besides the keyboard layout. Everything is really cut out, really amazing. For the screen you have 15.6 inch full HD display. This is really good display. And for the trackpad you have a decent amount of trackpads. Even around the trackpads there are some cool designs that will give you the feel of a gaming. Of course you will not be using the trackpad much because a gamer always needs a great mouse. That is there itself. So moving on to the next thing, the air vents. Here we have huge vents to dissipate the heat. Because of the gaming, you know, the gaming machines always produce a lot of heat. We have to dissipate it to overcome the thermal throttling and all. So that's why the vents are also really good. Overall, the build quality is really great. It feels solid in hand. The weight is around 2.2 kgs. Of course, gaming laptops are heavy out there. So that is all about the build quality. Now let's just speak about the main thing, that is the display on this machine. So for the display, you have got 15.6 inch bezel-less display. On the either side of the display, you have 6.5 mm clearance display, which is almost bezel-less display, which is really, really great. Of course, the chin and the notch of the screens are bigger. That is expected from the gaming machines, not a big deal over there. So great job, Asus there. So moving on to the next thing, that is the full HD display. You have the highlighted thing is the 144 Hertz refresh rate. We did test the games on this machine and the gaming experience was really, really good. The 144 Hertz refresh rate was really amazing. There are no motion blurs at all. I really liked it. So let's move on to the next thing, that is the main and the most awaited thing, that is the specs on this machine. For the specs, you have the Ryzen 7 3750H. That is the processor what the Asus is offering here. It has 4 cores and 8 threads, which is really amazing. And has a base clock frequency of 2.3 GHz and can turbo up to a 4 GHz. That is really, really amazing. And for the storage, we have the 512 NVMe M.2 SSD. Of course, SSDs are required in the modern world nowadays. So that's the thing. And for the expansion, you have got an 1 2.5-inch SATA empty slot present in the laptop itself. In case you want to extend your laptop storage, you can just pop in a SATA SSD or a SATA hard drive. That will be much easier for you. So now let's just speak about the RAM on this machine. We have got an 8GB single stick DDR4 clocked at 2400MHz. Of course, 2400MHz is a great speed for this machine. Of course, not a problem. And the RAM is expandable up to 32GB in dual channel configuration. That is really amazing. You have the expansion slot. Maybe it is storage, maybe it is the memory what you are going to use, I mean the RAM what you are going to use. Of course, they are upgradable. And moving on to the next thing, and the main and the core and the heart of the laptop, that is the graphic card. For the GPU, we have the NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1650. This is really, really amazing. Has a 4 GB of VRAM guys, and this is GDDR5 RAM, which means you are going to get amazing speeds out of this machine. That is really amazing. Now let's just move on to the game test. For the GTA 5, I tweaked all the settings to the max, whichever was available. I set the resolution to 1920x1080 pixels. There was no lags at all. The 144 Hertz refresh rate monitor really worked fine for me because there was no motion blurs at all. There was no frame drops. We were getting an average frame rate around 30 to 40 frames per second. But the main problem here is the fan noise. Yes, you heard me right. It is the fan noise. At the turbo performance, when you set the laptop to the turbo performance, of course the battery is going to degrade very fast because the fans will be at completely speed. Like, it was the heaviest noise I've ever heard. Even my CPU does not make such sounds but the noise was clearly audible. It will disturb you in your game. That's the different thing that you can manage it, which is really good. I did run Cinebench R20 score. I got a score of 1080 CB. This is really good for a machine which has 4 cores and 8 thread, 8 GB of RAM. This is expected to be that. The GPU worked really, really fine. Even at the 1920x1080 pixels, only 50% of the GPU was used. You had the room for another 2 GB to fit in or pop up any of the things you want. Now let's just speak about the connectivity. For the connectivity, you have, of course, first is the charging port, then comes the RJ45 pin for heavy gamers to get seamlessly connectivity between the internets. And next we have an USB 2.0 port, then two USB 3.1 Gen 2 ports for really amazing speeds. Then you have included a 3.5mm headphone jack. That is all the connectivity on the other side of the laptop. There is nothing, it is totally empty. I agree with this. And the heat dissipation is really good. At the back, you have a huge vents. Asus has claimed it to be an anti-dust fans, anti-dust cooling technology actually. That is really, really good. And you have some of the good sound quality as well. Of course, for the sound, you have 2 speakers, one is left and another is right. Even that is being given some textures, like the red tint it is already given. And this at the highs, when you pop it up to the 100%, there is a distortion, of course. In the mid-range, there is no distortion. Speakers are really great. So that is all the review for this laptop. Hey, what's up guys, this is Abhishek Garg. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Subscribe for more amazing content.